It's the Prime Minister! You don't want to step down? Mr. President, are you hyping up those stories about troops in Honduras? Are you hyping up those stories about troops in Honduras?
The White House is giving you the truth, as I think all of us know.
You mean it really was? How bad was this invasion? We hear there weren't as many people.
All that I can understand is that we knew there were two battalions, Bob. Now you go for the rough numbers of the battalions. Maybe those battalions were understrength or overstrength. We don't know on that. It's the exact number, but those battalions was a good number, around 1,500.
Why would they do that?
Going after American targets. Libya. They're talking about going after American targets.
They don't understand now. The exercise is over.
brevity. I'll keep my introduction of our honoree very short at this time so that he can introduce our special guest. Ladies and gentlemen, the next senator from the state of Louisiana, my friend, Representative Henson Moore.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Screaming, "Somebody quick, get me out of here." The lion jumped on him and said, "Shut up, you'll get both of us fired." Between the state and federal government had my support. Since then, Hanson Moore has been working, holding the line against costly add-ons. Yesterday, and the stock market reaching an all-time high, and if it continues what it's done in the first half of today, it'll be another all-time high by the end of the day, although with Wall Street, you know. somebody going up there. I'm aware of the economic troubles that persist here. Your difficulties make it absolutely essential that you have a senator who can command the respect of the public and of other elected officials. An individual who can lead Louisiana in the failures and hardships that brought America to the edge of a national economic calamity only 6 years ago. I'd like to hear your opinion. Does anyone else, anyone here, want to go back to the days of double-digit inflation, ever-increasing taxes, and national decline?
No!
Right. We can't leave the bad old days behind.
Rob Peter to pay Paul. They don't realize Peter went bankrupt a long time ago. The big taxers on Capitol Hill don't know when to stop. And we can't afford to let them regain control of the Senate. And that would leave us even bigger deficits. So what's the answer? Well, first and foremost, we must encourage growth and investment. Improving economic conditions are already making it easier to meet deficit reasons more.
Elected officials who would rather ask the federal government to tighten its belt than to ask American families to tighten theirs. Is complete. And this morning I telephoned the commander of the 6th Fleet and told him on behalf of all of you, the American people, congratulations one and all for a job well done. Korea, other places, and there and that maybe, I have to tell you, nothing in this job I have has made me more proud than the young Americans in uniform today. Is in our military today, and the highest are three intelligence brackets upon which various assignments are based. The highest percentage ever in our history. Lifeblood of our prosperity and our security. In many parts of the world, we regularly make clear that we do not recognize territorial claims. Send our young service people any place in the world where there is danger without them understanding that if somebody shoots at them, they can shoot back. America and our allies and the cause of freedom have never been. So I ask you to do what you can to see to it that America is given the benefit of.
President, what new terrorism? What new terrorism from Gaddafi were you talking about?
Your president, all I know is he is threatening worldwide terrorism.
And any new threats?
What?
New threats of terrorism?
No, he just kept on the same